usually like bantering with you in these intros and we come up with some sort of funny joke. Oh, I enjoy them too, buddy. But for this one, I think we should give back to the hockey community with a PSA.
You do? Oh, well, that's nice of you. What do you want to talk about?
Okay, thank you for this opportunity. Garnet Hathaway spit on a guy. He did spit on a guy. He got suspended for spitting on a guy.
Yeah, and like not the kind where it's like, ooh, like you accidentally spit on someone when you're talking.
No, like Hawk Tui.
It was a big Hawk Tui. He's gross.
Go Leafs.
Go Leafs.
Let's go!
Good. We all feel
stop!
Good.
Never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Into my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple yeet!
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Puppy Ziggy! We'll take it! They get 2 points either way! Right? That was low-key an impressive catch. You see that?
Dalton might care about how that game went, but the standings don't! Leafs win! 4-3 in overtime over the Philadelphia Flyers. This team. Dude, they gave up 15 shots the other day! 15! The other day! And in this one, they had given up 18 shots before it was even halfway through the game. And the reason I remember that milestone is because I forgot to keep track of when they hit 15. Like, the Flyers were well on their way to doubling up the Blues halfway through the game. The Leafs then decided to play immaculately. Like, dude, you know how sometimes there's a game where the Leafs play really, really well, really, really well, but they don't play a full 60 minutes and that's what costs them? They were the better team for one of the first three periods. And the fourth period, I mean, it's better than the shootout, but not by much. There is defense, though. The shootout's just, it's just a drill. Before we get going, this video is brought to you by SDP VIP. I decided that every week the Steve Dangle podcast is going to do a bonus episode. No, we're not taking one of the three regular podcasts and putting it behind a paywall. No, this is a bonus episode, which means you get 4 SDPs a week. That's if you become a member on the STPN YouTube channel or you subscribe to us under Apple Podcasts, and we're getting Spotify figured out. I don't think we're on there just yet. It's $3.99 a month. If we do one episode per week, which is the plan, that's $1 a show! And if you become a member on the YouTube channel, they'll put my smiling face. Or weird face, I think it's me doing the I'll put my face next to your name. Subscribe! SDP VIP is an opportunity for us to just hang out, goof around, and do all the extra stuff that we don't get to do because there's so much hockey news in the other three shows. If nothing else, it'll make me happy if you become a member. And my birthday's coming up. Do you want it? Can you do it for my birthday? It's in under a month. You have less than a month to get me a present! Anyway, thought I would throw that out there. SDP VIP. Now! Before we talk about this game, but still related to the game, and the Philadelphia Flyers, Sean Couturier is now the captain of the Philadelphia Flyers. Now, first and foremost, congratulations to Sean Couturier. He is underratedly one of the best stories in the NHL this season. I thought this guy was done. I didn't think he would play in the NHL again. And if he did, he wouldn't even be close to the same because he's missed so much time with so many significant injuries. Guess what? He comes back. He's incredible. And he's captain material for the Philadelphia Flyers, who have had some incredible captains over the years. That being said, it's a little weird the Flyers named him captain while on a road trip in Toronto. Like, forget the fact that it's in Toronto, just focus on the fact that it's not in Philadelphia. Like, okay, they're on a bit of a road trip, but like, February 24th, you're at home against the Rangers. We're at home against Winnipeg and Seattle and Arizona, like, less than a week ago. I don't know, that's weird, right? That's a little why. Like, I've been sitting here trying to come up with a reason. I don't want to be like, oh, Toronto, center of the hockey universe. He's the Flyers' captain. The Flyers play in Philadelphia. Name him the captain while you're in Philadelphia. Your last game before this one was in Philadelphia. Yeah, I don't get that one. That's weird.
Anyway, wow, do we not know what to expect from this team each and every shift? Dude, last game they didn't have Riley, they didn't have Marner, they didn't have Tavares. They put together their greatest work of art and only allowed 15 shots against a Blues team that sucked and frankly didn't even look like they were trying, but it was a good effort. Bobby McMahon had a hat trick. And during the first period of this one, there really wasn't a moment where the Leafs looked like the better team. Like, the Flyers were violent. They were vicious. They were hitting and, I mean, really trying. But outside of the physicality, which in so many games is all you need to do to neutralize the Leafs, they're still just a paper tiger when it comes to snot. But the Leafs get a gift, the only power play of the first period, and they give it away. Sean Walker, who might be a Leaf pretty soon, who knows, depends who you ask, he puts it over the glass. Guess what? Leafs power play. And guess what? The Philadelphia Flyers with their league leading, 12th shorthanded goal. And listen, I like giving teams credit for doing good things rather than blaming teams for making a mistake. But the second unit's out there on this power play, which just stop putting them out there. Let the first unit go for 2 minutes. Oh, Steve, they're gonna be tired after the 2 minute. Yeah, then put the second unit out or whatever you want out after, because they completely goof the entry. Mark Giordano posts up like, I'm gonna help. But like, the Leafs are already mid turnover. You're not helping get back. He doesn't get back. Breakaway. By a miracle, the puck doesn't go in. Puck stays in the Leaf zone. Here's the problem. If you take a look at the screenshot, how many Leafs are in that one spot? It looks like two. It's actually three. Max Domi doesn't have three legs. That's three guys. They're all forwards. I'm not an X's and O's guy, but I'm positive at least one of you is not where you're supposed to be. By that virtue, you'd assume they're all in the wrong. All those forwards are in the wrong. Mark Giordano showed veteran leadership and said, I'll join ya. Mark! Why? Robertson's right there. He's right there. It's handled. It's fine. It's all fine, Mark. And this is the final product. Just hang it in the poov, which is the Louvre. But made of poo. Travis Sanheim scores his fifth of the season. That's trash. The whole thing. If you could bench all five guys right at once, you would. That's how the Leafs go into intermission, down 1-0 and getting outshot 10-8. Nick Seeler and Bobby McMahon get into it at the final horn for the first period, so it's a little bit of 4-on-4 action to start the second. A little bit spicy, still doesn't add up to anything. The Flyers are shutting the Leafs down, shutting them down, shutting them down. They're physical, but they're just giving them nothing. And I had my hands on my phone, my thumbs were out, I was ready to give it to them. And then the Flyers made a grave mistake. They let Austin Matthews shoot. Like, it wasn't the best coverage from the Flyers, but most players don't score that goal. But it's Austin Matthews and he's a mutant! That's his 43rd assist from Marner and the Leafs tie it up. Hey, maybe that's the play you needed. You're not playing that great, but you got that. Oh, the Flyers just took a penalty. Let's see if we can build on it. You can because of Austin Matthews. Dude, Mike Johnson broke this down perfectly on the broadcast. It's Marner to Matthews for the one-timer. Obviously, Matthews takes the one-timer and scores. It's not even in that great of a position. Like, look at this. Yeah, he gets it clean. Like, he gets all of this puck. But the distance from the net, the angle, you're gonna give up shots on the penalty kill. It's kind of inevitable at some point. This is not the worst shot to give up, generally speaking, but it's Austin Matthews! Tampa Bay is very good at this. How did that even go in? Oh, it's Kucherov. Oh, that makes sense. That's his second of the game, 44th of the season. Shout out Morgan Riley. And then a few minutes later, before the end of the second period, actually a great play from Timothy Liljegren, who I've been all over recently. Flyers try to clear the puck. Liljegren whacks it down with his glove, and it just stays onside. It looks like Liljegren's pausing to see if it actually stays onside. I think he's leaving it for Matthews, who's right there. Matthews wisely doesn't touch it because that's a hand pass. And you see Liljegren go, oh, and then he darts for the puck that he knocked down, sends it to Austin, and again, it's not the most threatening shot in the world, but it's Austin Matthews! Another Hattie for Maddie. The Leafs are up 2, heading into the third. Everyone feels good, especially the dude at the ACC, Scotiabank Arena, especially the dude at Scotiabank Arena who sells hats. Third period starts, they're feeling good, they're continuing, it's a little bit more of it. The Flyers team that we saw in the first and the early part of the second, they're gone, they're not even really trying. They're not throwing as many hits. They were woken up a little bit by Simone Benoit deciding, I don't like Cam York anymore and I don't want him to be here. Turns the kid into a crater. Nicolas Deslauriers gets in there and even his response is just, Few rabbit punches, Russell to the ground. And the Leafs get a power play out of it. No, the Leafs do not score on that power play, but it was pretty good. Like, they were getting their looks. A couple minutes later, Konechny hooks Giordano. Giordano goes down very easy, and Konechny off for the hook. Gio off for embellishment. Now remember, the penalty is not diving. It's embellishment. A lot of people say, well, hey, it can't be the penalty and embellishment at the same time. That's not true. Embellishing is when something happens to you during a game, you get tripped, you get hooked, whatever it is. It's when something happens to you, an infraction, a penalty, but you embellished it. Instead of just sort of, you know, moving your hips a little, you fall all over the place, which is what happened here, if we're being fair. I think there should be a whole other penalty for dudes who, like, a stick comes up, but it doesn't make any contact with them at all, and they go, oh! Like, there should be an embellishment penalty and a diving penalty. Embellishment is 2 minutes. Hey, don't do that. Diving should be game misconduct. I don't care. Not a 5 minute major, just you're out of the game for being a diving baby. Anyway, the game's going, and it's going well. Leafs are playing loosey-goosey. They're trying to get Matthews his fourth. He almost gets it. And then Noah Gregor, so far away from anything relevant, in the offensive zone, dude, takes a roughing penalty. He argues that you could send both guys. You can't. This is another one where I'm going to be fair even as a Leaf fan. Yes, both guys were jousting, which is the dumbest term ever in the NHL's interpretation of the rules. It's so stupid. But they were jousting. Gregor is the one who punched the guy. The Flyers do not score on that power play, but shortly after, Garnet Hathaway, he crashes the net, he scores, and he stinks. He's not very good. It's only his fifth goal of the season, which is less than Tyler Bertuzzi, and that guy can't hit the broadside of a barn. And Hathaway says to Liljegren after the goal, get out of here, and he pushes him, get out of here before I spit on you, because he spit on a guy. I don't think we should ever forget that he spit on a guy. And now the Flyers are not only within one, but, like, the fire's back. You saw from their celebration, you're like, you know it's a regular season game, right? No, they were on one. They were going off. So when Tyler Bertuzzi decides it's his turn to take an offensive zone penalty, an inexcusable offensive zone penalty, you knew it was a problem. And Travis Konechny gets his 26th of the season already to get the Flyers tied. Dude, Sammy was so good in this game. Like, sometimes I obviously think about what I'm gonna say in these videos ahead of time, and I was thinking about the themes. While it's 3-1 and the Leafs look like they're gonna lock it down no problem, I wanted to talk about how low-key good, like just understatedly good, Sammy has been. His first couple games back, he was really good and everyone gave him his props. Then, you know, it's actually been a few weeks since he came back and has sort of been his usual Sammy self. And we haven't really talked about it, good or bad. That is great! I don't want to have to think about him. Earlier in the season, I thought about him a whole lot. So to just have a goalie who just sort of shows up, stops pucks, and goes home is great! And the Leafs completely let him down in the third period. They really did. Luckily for the Leafs, they survive to overtime. The Flyers get their point. Yeah, sure, enjoy. But the Leafs pick up the dub. Flyers with the bad line change, the bad coverage in general. Liljegren, another real good pass from a similar spot, this time to William Nylander, snipes it past Sammy Ursin, who loses the Battle of the Sammies, by the way. And William Nylander decided, no, I don't like you, Travis Konechny. He passes him and gets his 27th of the season. It's good. It's good. Stay hot, Willie. He was in a bit of a slump. Stay hot, Willie. Good for Willie to get that, too. You saw the clip going around of him talking to Sheldon on the bench, and they're arguing about something. He didn't have a great game. That whole line, it wasn't great. Like, they started with Pontus Holmberg on their wing, and then he was replaced with Tyler Bertuzzi, who got benched. Not great! But the ending, great. And special shout out to Timothy Liljegren. That's a great game, and he assisted on the OT winner. Before we get to questions, let's do a little Marley Minute with Nick Barden. Now, we've been focusing a lot on individual players, who's going to get called up, who potentially has trade value, and we're going to talk about that more as the trade deadline approaches, March 8th, by the way. But, unfortunately, low-key, the Marlies have not been very good. Here's Nick Barden to talk about it.
After going 5-2-0-1 on their boat show road trip, the Marlies returned home, and it hasn't been as easy for them. Toronto got off to a great start after they returned home, beating Laval Rocket on Friday 6-1. But the next day, Laval came back and handed the Marlies a 7-1 loss. And to make matters worse, this past Wednesday, they played the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins and lost to them 6-1. Following Wednesday's game, Marlies captain Logan Shaw called the last couple of losses embarrassing, not just for the team, but for the entire organization. One area that struggled a fair bit as of late is goaltending. Dennis Hildeby last Friday allowed 4 goals on 19 shots and was pulled, and Keith Petruzzelli came in for relief, and he allowed 3 goals on 12 shots against Laval. And then on Wednesday, with Hildeby up with the Leafs, the Marlies went with Petruzzelli, and he gave up 5 goals on 31 shots to the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins. Petruzzelli is now at an .868 save percentage through 16 games in the AHL this season, and when Marlies head coach John Gruden was asked about the goaltender's play, he said that they win as a team and they lose as a team, and collectively they've got to fight through it. But looking at a few of the Maple Leafs prospects on the Marlies, what matters more, team success or individual development? Honestly, both go hand in hand. Winning fosters development, but you can only develop so much if you're on a team that loses constantly. However, if you're on a team that wins a lot, you'll be part of a winning culture, which can push a player's development even further.
It'd be great if the Marlies could turn it around, but it's going to be hard with Dennis Hildeby up on the team right now. I don't know if you noticed who the backup was. Everyone is talking about Matthews getting 70 goals, but the real question is, is he getting 40 assists? Who cares? Forget Matthew scoring 40 assists. I'm waiting for anyone in the bottom six to reach 20. Like outside of Domi, Bueller, anyone. You know what? The problem is you need to score to get an assist. Like the team needs to score in order. Like you need to pass the puck and then a player has to score. And apparently if you're not one of the core four forwards, you're not even allowed to crack double digits. Like Nyes is sitting at 9, Robertson's at 7 or 8. I know Yarncroke cracked double digits and then they're like, no. And then the conspiracy happened and he got injured and now he's out of the lineup because they're like, that's not allowed. Steve, another Leafs blown lead. Flyers always find a way to come back. How much better do you feel knowing another Austin Matthews hattie wasn't wasted? Yeah, a weird amount of Matthews hat tricks end up either as losses or games that go to overtime. And I'm glad they didn't screw it up. Because they blew a 3-1 lead in this one. You know a game where they blew a 4-1 lead? I know what you're thinking of. And no, you're thinking of the wrong game. I'm talking about the Centennial Classic against the Detroit Red Wings. It's true. The Leafs had a 4-1 lead. They blew it in the final minute, and none of you remember that because Matthews won it in overtime, and it doesn't matter that they blew a 4-1 lead. Just win! Woo! So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. SDPN YouTube channel, SDPN on Apple, and soon to be Spotify. I mean, it's already on Spotify, just not SDP VIP. Go to the SDPN YouTube channel, SDP VIP. It's $4 a month, less a cent. You won't regret it. Brand new episode dropping too. Woo!